It is five of the five top sins that keep many Christians single who would like to be married one day. Number one, fear. The key to entering into a romantic relationship is for two people to feel like they're both authentically connected with each other. If someone is struggling with fear, the people around them will sense this, and thus it would be very hard for that person to truly connect with anyone. 1 John 4, verses 18 through 19 explains, there's no fear in love, but perfect love casts out fear. For fear has to do with punishment, and whoever fears has not been perfected in love. We love because we first loved us. Hallelujah. One thing can be seen in the world, oftentimes we do not fully embrace the love of Jesus. Only when you know the love of God, you will have the confidence and freedom to express yourself to other people in an authentic way. Number two, pride. When someone is prideful, it makes everyone around them feel like they're getting pushed down and devalued. It's impossible for prideful people to have a healthy relationship because pride makes you put yourself above others. And that is the opposite goal. A healthy Christian relationships. When you are living in pride, you are lacking God's favor. For as James 4 verse 6 states, God opposes the proud, but gives grace to the humble. Hallelujah. Number three, sexual immorality. The definition of sexual immorality is any sexual acts done between two people who are not married. God makes sexual experiences to be enjoyed only in a protected and committed context of marriage. When unmarried people share sexual experiences, rather than bonding them together in a covenant and an altar, this keeps them apart. Sexual sin keeps people single, because once you get pulled into it, it's very hard to get out. A soul tie, you're addicted to sex, masturbation, or pornography. The bondage you are in will prevent you from freely interacting with the opposite sex with pure and biblical motive. All this contributes to prolonged season of unwanted sickness. And one area of the solution is that you do repentance and renouncing the sins. Another area is Hebrews 13 says, let marriage be held in honor among all, and let the marriage bed be undefiled, for God will judge the sexual immoral adulteress. Number four, unequally yoked relationships. One of the biggest barriers being a right relationship is being in the wrong relationship. As 2 Corinthians 6 states, 14 and 18 warn against. Unequally yoked relationship often cause people to waste years with someone they know they would never marry. Certainly God's grace is enough to cover any sin. God created the universe out of nothing, so it's not a hard thing for him to create a marriage for someone who wasted large parts of their life in bad relationships. Nevertheless, yoked to someone that you're not equally on a spiritual level. Christians secretly that unequal yoke must be high on the list. And number five, idolatry. Idolatry keeps you single or leads you into unholy relationships because God will not bless you with something that will pull you further away from his presence and also having a personal relationship. You can be in a relationship without God blessing, will not be a blessing from God. Rather than it will be a disaster, it will be in a curse in your life. It will take you further and further from the joy of the Lord that is yours when you walk in obedience. Hallelujah. Idolatry not only dishonor God, it's also damaging to yourself, your temple, everything you touch. When God is what you worship in your heart, mind, and soul, you're also free to rejoice in blessings he wants to give you as you keep them in the right place. Is a few videos you can find on a YouTube account, and you will find it in the comment box up top. And also, if you would like to plant a seed, we're working with orphanages in Malawi and Kenya, and also in Nigeria. And also, we're asking for strong support for the Recovery United programs. There's a campaign link somewhere in the comment box. May God bless you, may God keep you, and continue to shine his face upon you. Shalom.